So my name's Chris. I'm going to be giving you a little flavour of my PhD project, which is on WrapToR composite truss structures. So to start off, I'll just give you a brief introduction to the WrapToR truss concept. So WrapToR stands for WrapToR reinforced truss. So this is what it looks like here in this image up there. So this technology essentially combines three building blocks. So first off, we're using a truss geometry. So truss geometry is often used in structural applications where you want a really high structural efficiency. They achieve high structural efficiency by primarily moving material away from the axis of bending, but they also create a structure in which each of the members is primarily loaded axially. So composite materials, we all love composites, but realistically the applications where composites really excel are those where there's a sort of dominant loading direction or dominant stress direction, and that direction is known. And in those cases we can align the fibres with that dominant loading direction and maximise material properties. So there's a bit of a synergy that goes on here, because if you've got a structure in which all of the members are primarily axially loaded, then you can align the fibres with that direction, get a really efficient geometry that maximises the material properties. Composite trusses aren't really anything new though, so what's special about this technology really is the manufacturing process. And I'll show you that in a video on the next slide, but essentially it's very similar to filament winding. And being similar to filament winding, we get a lot of the same benefits. So we can use low-cost constituents, it's repeatable, and you get a high level of automation. So here's a quick video to show you the process. So at the back here we've got four carbon fibre toes that are spun together. This then comes down for a resin bath, and that's then laid onto this mandrel, and the mandrel consists of three carbon fibre tubes which run along the length. So that's an introduction to the concept, and I'm just going to talk about my work on the project. So we've been doing a lot of manufacturing work. One of the studies we did there was looking at the effect of twisting the carbon fibre toe. So what we found was if you twisted the carbon fibre toe, you get shear members with a circular section. So that's the image on the right there. And what we found that does is that really improves the buckling, the buckling resistance of the shear members and create a better structural efficiency. We've also been looking at concept scaling, so we want to go much larger than this. So there's an image of a multi-spooling device that I came up with. And then we've also looked at going to more complex geometry. So we've done some taper trusses and been thinking about maybe doing some curved geometries. And then a large part of my work's been on analysis. So we want to be able to predict the structural response of these trusses. The main way we've been doing that is by using beam elements. So each of the truss members is represented as a beam. I'm just going to talk you through one of the key findings from that work. So if you model each member as a beam element, we found there wasn't a particularly good agreement between the experiment and the analysis. So there's a bit of a problem at the truss joints if you're going to represent each member as a beam, because they don't really match up at a point. There's an eccentricity. So with the original model, all we did was simply increase the shear member angle so that they all met at a point. And that gave you the results that are on the left there. What we found is a much better way of modelling it is if we use the actual geometry and then we include a joint member. And we found this allowed us to model both displacements at the node and better model the bending moments that are transferred between the members. And you can see that gives us a much better fit. So just finishing up on the future work. So a lot of the work we've been doing has been on stiffness analysis. If we want to take this into any real application, we need to be able to predict when it fails. So strength is a big next part. We want to go larger again, see how well this concept scales. Then hopefully once we've got strength predictions, we can also do some optimization, because that'd be really useful for designing for any application. And then finally, we want to look at trying to apply it to an application. So here's an image of a drone project that we've got running with the trusses at the moment. So that's everything from me. I will have quite a few of these at my stand, at my poster, so please come along, have a play with them. They're really quite impressive and quite fun to play with. Yeah. Cool, thank you very much.